Alright, so this is my stamp video part 2. Here I'm just trying to do a little bit of a better job. This is for all you people out there that are doing Remembrance Day this weekend.
Yeah.
I'm just going to have to throw some more music on for our stamp video here in about 2 seconds. Just finished showing some United States postage stamps. So there's a 20 center there. Another one, but it's a little more beat up. You can see it says 1944 on it, though. So just bear with here for a sec, and I'm going to throw on a tune by Fleetwood Mac. There we go. Continue on. Happens when you're an important guy, I suppose. I believe that's Netherlands airmail stamp. And then I have one more here I want to show, and that is of Bermuda. Very beautiful postage stamp. And what else do I have on that page? Oh yeah, just a lot of stamps here. Republic of Togolese. 1,500, 400, 250. So we'll skip forward to next page. Throw in another song here quick. Keep the tunes going. Up in the morning, sky is cloudy and stormy. Don't listen to who's on the run. Stay in the light, keep your talk here inside. Don't listen to who's on the run. Hopefully you guys are all bearing with here still. Here's a couple German stamps, I believe. Duchess White. Area post up. You guys are bearing with. This is not no easy task to do, considering I'm holding the loop and one hand and trying to run the camera on the other. There's an old United States 2 cent cut off the cover. This is my amateur video. I'm not a professional, you know. I wish I had a really good camera where I could just position it and then flip through and you could see, but I think I'm doing a pretty good job. I'm just throwing another song here. That's another one in mind. Gives me something to listen to as well. Velveeta, so that's Swiss. I really like that. The lines on that one is pretty cool. So there's actually a few Swiss stamps, and some of my stamps I've never even looked at before. Because when I discovered them all, I actually kind of inherited them all to somebody. So I never took them out of the cards. eBay was trying to call me a frauder and shit, but it ain't true. All my stuff's the real deal. Because it's not graded. You know, and people shouldn't have to get their shit graded. You know, this sucks you further in the collectible part. That's what a good picture's for, right? So you can see the condition it's in. And if you like it still, then you like it. But at one point in time, I had a shit camera. And I was picking random prices because, you know, I'm a first-time seller, so I don't know what anything's worth. But now I'm banned for life, and they picked on me, trying to say trademark violations and shit. Whatever. I don't need them. It's my power struggle videos. Trying to get my shit out there so you guys can see it. What one man can hoard away. I collect everything. Records, coins, stamps, guitars, pennies. Stuff in terrible condition. Stuff in good condition. As long as I had one. And this is my second collection in my lifetime, because at one point I lost everything in a house fire and never thought I'd collect things again. And I've been showing you guys some videos, and this is stuff I have now, and I'm not going to stop collecting. King of the fight, it's the most stamps that you've ever seen, yeah. Well, maybe not the most stamps you've ever seen, but look at that, 3 Anna. That is nice. She's an oldie. Damn, damn, damn. Canadian registered mail. Yeah, I was trying to sell everything I had to have a better life for myself. I'm not in a very good position right now. I'm going to end up doing some stuff that I don't really want to do because I couldn't sell anything. Maybe my luck will change. I sell myself on eBay. I've never tried that. I'd sell myself on a date. Tried all kinds of things. But today, I'm just here to help you guys remember what's important. People from all around the world. Because you are as lucky as I am. And do you know the reason why? Because you have an opportunity to be here just the same as me and make choice. And the only thing you really have is your family when it comes down to it. Good or bad. You can't take everything with you. But you can sure in the heck admire it while you're here. And where my stamp collection will end up, I'll never know. But I might know who I hand it down to next, or whoever buys it while I'm here, kind of thing. Let's say I didn't sell my stamp collection. At least I put it in books, so someday somebody else will find it. Italy. So my stamp collection concentrates on stamps from all across the world. Obviously you guys are seeing that. I have Canada, USA, Russian stamps, lots of different republics, stamps from France, stamps from Brazil, just piles of different ones. Lots of USA stamps. Some are like in good condition. See, it doesn't even look like it's been used. Singapore. You know, people from all over the world are important to me. Because when I'm gone, you know, they'll never see anybody ever again. Fergie, Swedish stamps. Argentina. Israeli stamps. They're asking a lot of money for some of those. I left people with the question, who's going to go to Israel to get Israeli stamps if you're a white man, kind of thing, you know? And war is a bad thing. And I guess that was kind of an ignorant statement. So I would take that back. I think that people should want to see the world and see different cultures in different ways. And take in the experiences that you can when you are here. As wise man once said, life is like a dash. Not the numbers at the beginning, and it's not the numbers at the end. It's that little dash in between, and what you do with that little bit of time while you're here. That's all that really matters. Malta. Here's some from New Guinea. Very beautiful. I love stamps from New Guinea. Well, hopefully I make it through these last couple pages of this book. I rushed through the other half of this book in my last video, which I have posted on YouTube already. But I have a lot more stamps than just this binder full. And we're going to go through some more books. I'm going to be making some more videos. And I have some specialty ones as well to show off. Mm-hmm. India. I heard India stamps were really super popular for a while here too, and China, USA, but you know, look at this one, Uzbekistan. Like, how did this stamp end up in this collection? Or Dufar, you know? Like, whoever collected these stamps went out of their way to get ones from different countries and stuff. And they're not all new either. There's ones that go all the way back to the 1800s, and there's ones from the mid 1950s and 60s and 70s. So it's a pretty neat collection altogether. State of Oman. I've never been these places. That's why I wanted to sell my stamps, so I could go see the world maybe someday. Anyways, I'm gonna throw Eye of the Tiger back on for a sec. I like that song. And finish up this last little bit of stamps in this book. Apparently that's a good stamp right there. I know it's upside down, but at least you can take a look. So here's a good one. That's the Japan, United States stamp. It's got like a peace monument in it. Good one for Remembrance Day, that's for sure. Coming up tomorrow. I want you guys to take a look at my other stamp videos, because I'm going to do some more today. It'll take a while for me to upload, because I have a crappy computer, not like some people. But I'll do my best to show you guys what I got. Like I said, power struggle, it's the will to survive. Love you all. Not even gonna answer it. Could be important. Might not be too. What's that? Egypt. Central Africa. Equatorial Guinea. Philippines. Diamond Jubilee stamp. Here's one from the Civil War. Any war is a bad war, as far as I'm concerned. British Honduras. New Zealand. Too bad it's not the old one, but look at that one. That's a nice New Zealand stamp. like I said, my collection consists of different ones, different years. 1933 Royal William ship. There's a guy that's been gone for a long time. Kennedy. Republic of Malagash. I don't know if I pronounced that right. Some more stamps from France. Democratic Republic. If you're bearing with me here, this is quite the task. There's Zimbabwe, Rassel, Kayamia. I don't know if I said that right either. Just a couple minutes left to finish off this part of my stamp video, and then we're going to be working on the next book. There's actually a lot of stamps there. Probably a full set of some sort, I imagine. And there's more stamps from Norway. Different ones. United States with the buffalo on it. What's this? Really nice train stamp. 500 overprint. Some other kind of interesting stamp. I'm not really sure what stamp that is. Canada. A lot of 3 cent Canadian stamps. I believe this is from the 1948 Olympics. So if you guys are seeing anything in the collection, or you're interested in the whole collection altogether, give me a shout. Big year. Are you going to do a big year? Just recently seen that movie. It was actually a pretty good movie about bird watching. A little free advertisement for Jack Black, I suppose. He in the big year, you're going to find a reasonably new movie, like I said, about bird watching. It was actually a pretty good movie. Look at that. That's a cool one. I like that one. The Duchess Rake stamps are pretty neat. This is a rupee from Indonesia. And then, what country is this? Kenya. So there's some stamps from Kenya. And that was San Marino. And then soil conservation. It's a good one to bring up because we need to take care of our planet. So this is the last page in this stamp book. So we're going to finish off here. And then I'm going to upload this and get it out there for you guys to take a look at. United States. Couple more of the Queen. Some more stamps from Italy, I believe. Some different variations and colors. So here's one from Turkey. St. Vincent stamp, really nice. You guys are seeing all this. Canada, that was Austria. So there we have it. And now I'm just gonna download this movie for you and get it out there so you guys can take a look at the second half of that book. And then we're gonna move into some different books of stamps. Anyways, my name's Ben, and we'll have a moment of silence for everybody tomorrow. Remembrance Day. And in my town, in Quesnel, BC, during the moment of silence, they actually fly planes over, and it really sets the mood, I suppose. So I'm going to be going down and putting a reef on the monument in town. Because that's what I do, because my grandpa was a war vet. I'm going to leave you with that, and you guys have a good day. And all you stamp collectors out there, I hope you enjoy my video.